Hi there and welcome to another episode of the KAOS Information Exchange. My name is Bill Bates and today I am going to try to not tell you how to buy a digital piano. I'm going to tell you, or try to tell you anyway, why you might buy a Yamaha Avant Grand digital hybrid piano. Because the reason I'm doing this video is the digital hybrid's a brand new product and it's not like any digital piano you've ever seen. And it's not an acoustic piano. So it's not a digital piano, it's not an acoustic piano. The question is, what is it? And once people find out what it is, this piano is applicable to many people's situation and they end up buying it. But it's kind of tricky because it's brand new to know exactly what it is. So I'm gonna try to explain. An Avant Grand is the piano here right behind me, and it looks like a small baby grand. And the reason they call it a hybrid piano is because it is kind of got components from an acoustic piano and it has elements of a digital piano built into it. And a traditional digital piano, one that you've come to know up until now, has electronics that create the sound, and it has a modified keyboard that feels somewhat weighted like a real piano, and it replicates a real piano feel. And it does a pretty good job, but most people that play real pianos or have played real pianos in the past would all agree that it doesn't feel exactly like a real piano. And the playing experience, although is pretty good for what they would call an imitation of a digital piano, it's not like playing the real thing. It's just kind of like playing an instrument that's like the real thing. And they in people who play and really demand an acoustic piano feel don't like digital pianos that much. And that's why Yamaha has moved towards the hybrid. The hybrid has in it, the keybed is the exact same keybed design as their CF series grand pianos. And that is a much deeper, more mechanical, real piano feel, piano action mechanism that's in there, same as it's in their concert piano. So when you play it, it doesn't feel like an imitation piano. It feels like a real piano because it is a real piano action. To make the whole thing feel more real, they put in the piano and in the body of the piano and under the keys of the piano, they're little solenoids, but they vibrate. And this is called their tactile response system. And as you play on a real piano, a real acoustic piano that is, when you play, the whole thing vibrates. The strings are vibrating and the whole thing, you can feel it in your fingers. On a digital piano, like a traditional digital piano, you can't feel that. What they've done is they put in these little vibrating tactile response sensor things, and when you play, it vibrates. So it feels like a real piano, even though you've got a real action, you've got a real keybed in there. Without those, it wouldn't vibrate. So it does, it vibrates like a real piano, which is awesome. So the sound part of the Avant Grand is digital, and it's their Yamaha's way most advanced digital sample technology put into a piano. So no need to bore you with specifications of how many megabytes and what have you, but suffice to say that every key on the instrument is sampled or digitally recorded multiple times and then assembled into an awesome digital sound. It's played through their most advanced PA system ever on a digital system. And you know what? I've forgotten how many speakers. It's like 14 speakers, some odd like that. And they're placed throughout the instrument so that when you're playing certain notes on the piano, that sound would be coming out where it would be coming out of a real piano as well. So it's not that just it has a big PA system, it has a very elaborate PA system built into it, all the way through the piano, out the bottom, subwoofers in it to create the big bottom end that you feel on a real piano. That combined with the vibrating things that are in the keys, and that combined with the fact that the keys themselves are a real piano, all go together to make a hybrid piano. So I hope that explains what's different about this piano than a normal piano. The normal digital piano only has a replicated keybed, which doesn't feel as good as a real piano. This has an actual piano key mechanism, which not surprisingly feels like a real piano key mechanism because it is a real piano key mechanism. So put that all together with an unbelievably good sound, and when you sit down to play this, the idea is that it feels and sounds like you're playing a 9-foot grand piano in a 3-foot something mini grand piano, but it feels like a big one. So the market, who's this piano for? Well, if you're a homeowner and you'd like to have a grand piano, but you don't have the space for it, it might be for you because it fits in a much smaller footprint. Condo owners often buy this because condos, even big condos, have small areas for an instrument, like in a nice bay window. We've sold a few that go in a beautiful bay window overlooking the city, and it's great, but a real baby grand wouldn't fit there. People who are in homes where there's volume issues, like with children sleeping, and you only have the opportunity to play in the evening when kids are sleeping, and that obviously limits it. It excludes that time that you can play because everyone's sleeping, and regular piano is too loud. It's for those people as well. If you're teaching, this delivers the feel of a real piano, again, because it has a real piano key bed in it, without the maintenance of an acoustic piano. You don't have to tune this piano ever because the sound part of it's digital. You can adjust the keys on it like a real acoustic. A real acoustics can have the keys adjusted and regulated so they can feel different. You can do that here because, again, you have a real key bed to work with. So it's for people who might be teaching and want an instrument with no maintenance, much easier to move around. This baby grand weighs about 480 pounds. A real baby grand would weigh well in excess of 1,000 pounds. So there's a big difference in weight as well. So if you're a family or an individual who would like a baby grand or a grand piano, would like all the benefits of owning a grand piano, which is primarily how it sounds and feels, but don't have the room or the budget for a decent grand piano, which is going to run in the, at the very low end, $15,000 or so for a quality, inexpensive grand piano, small size, could be as much as $50,000. There's all sorts of pianos in that range. This is in the $15,000 range, so it's like buying the cheapest good grand piano you could buy, an acoustic grand, but this has the components of a much more expensive grand piano in the keys itself. So you would be getting better quality keys and all the benefits of no tuning, volume control, smaller size. So these are all the things that make the Avant Grand a potential piano for a lot of people. So now that you know that it's not really a digital piano, even though it is digital, so it's got the elements of an acoustic piano and real elements and feels and delivers a playing experience like playing an actual grand piano. Now that you know that, and you know that it's the price range that it's in and the size that it is and the benefits of owning it, it may be the right piano for you. It may not still. If you are looking for a grand piano and you have a budget and the size and no volume restraints and you really want a grand piano, I wouldn't be surprised in the least if you didn't buy the Avant Grand. But if you have any of those constraints that I mentioned, like size and volume and budget, I would be happy to let you know now what this is about. I'm happy that I was able to bring this video to you so you know what this is about. The next step for anyone is to try it and see if they agree with the playing experience. We're pretty confident because hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands, of professionals around the world have played this piano, and they all agree it feels like a real piano. And again, not surprisingly, because it is real grand piano keybed and sounds awesome, and people have endorsed it all over the world. So, but that's those people. You have to try it, and if you try it and decide you like it, it might be the right piano for you, it might not be, but at least now you know what the Avant Grand is. Lastly, I'll tell you that there's a few versions of it. The N3, which is this version, is the grand style version of it. I'm not going to show it, but you can see it online. There's a upright version of it, which is kind of a misnomer because it looks like an upright piano, but it's got the grand action, grand keys in it. So you look at it and say, well, that one probably feels like an upright. No, it feels like a grand piano as well because it has the same key bed in it, but it looks like an upright on the outside. But the way it still feels exactly the same as this, and that's called the N2. And the only difference is the N2 has less elaborate pedals. This has actual grand piano pedals, which are very specific and feel a very specific way. It has upright type pedals, and it has a much smaller, less elaborate PA system. Does it sound a lot worse? No, it doesn't. It sounds very much the same. Not quite as good. This PA system is really something that's in here. The N2 is very good sounding and feels every bit 100% the same as the N3. And coming in the summer, I guess now, is the N1, which is the same key bed again in an upright format, but without the vibrating tactile response solenoid gizmo use. So the thing won't vibrate under your fingers like these two do, which will be a step down, but that'll be a lot less expensive. The N2 is under 10,000. The N1 will be, I don't know yet, 5 or 6. So there you have it. The N3 Avant Grand from Yamaha. Definitely worth checking out for a whole bunch of reasons, which hopefully you now know what they are. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again next time.